and welcome to Movies to Video Games Reviews. Video games that won't be reviewed here and why. PlayStation 1. Definitely not reviewable. These games did not make the cut to be applicable. The following games will not be reviewed here as a regular episode for various reasons. Reasons for not being applicable are listed with each game. 007 Racing, based around the James Bond franchise, but not based on a movie or movies itself. It has elements and characters that were established in the series of films that were made up to its release date, but that is all that it really has in common with the films. It isn't even a multi-movie based game, as it's more of a racing game that has you taking control of cars seen in the various movies that James Bond drove. It's another game that uses the franchise in a new experience, using elements from the franchise rather than truly related. So nope. Austin Powers Pinball, another spin-off based off of a movie franchise and only movie based in the most general of senses. It's basically a no-frills pinball game that uses pinball tables based on the first two movies of the Austin Powers series. It does have nods to a lot of things found within, like Fembots and Dr. Evil, but definitely not something I can review here or fit into either of the films properly, even if it references said films. This game is just too far removed from the movies, and it won't be reviewed here as it just doesn't fit properly in this type of format. A Bug's Life Activity Center. An interesting game that is a point-and-click game for younger audiences that is themed around the Pixar movie A Bug's Life. It's not fitting for two reasons to this channel's criteria. For one, it's a European exclusive game, and as of now I don't do games that are not North American release games as part of a regular episode. But also it's more of a spin-off rather than a game based on the movie. So it's not the true movie-based game, unlike the actual movie-based game that is also found on the PlayStation, and was released in all markets and could be reviewed here. Die Hard Trilogy 2, Viva Las Vegas. While called Die Hard Trilogy, it actually is not based off of any of the films. It is a follow-up and a direct sequel to the first game that did base itself off of the first three movies. This one though has nothing to do with any of the movies and is a new and original story that captures the flavor of the Die Hard series, but nothing else that is directly from the storyline of the films. And this show doesn't do spin-offs or sequels of movies specific to games only. It definitely captures the flavor and feel of a Die Hard movie, but it's all original story-wise and doesn't fit into the show. Disney's Aladdin, Nasira's Revenge. This game is weird in that it's another game that is continuing of events and storyline based off of content from the movie, but is not connected to anything else. The game has Aladdin from the Disney movie of the same name, dealing with Jafar's sister as she is trying to revive Jafar. And this game's events actually take place after the made-to-video movie Return of Jafar, but before the TV show that followed said sequel movie. It's connected to the series, but it is all original content and a new story that is based directly into this game and nowhere else. It's a fun adventure and follow-up to the Aladdin films, but it's not really based off of any of the movies, so it doesn't fit here. Even if it has all the familiar characters and references, it still isn't a movie-based game. Disney's Story Studio, Mulan. More of a spin-off game that uses the events from the film in a different way than an actual movie-based game. This takes events, situations, and characters from the Disney movie Mulan and makes for a fun point-and-click and interactive experience for the younger audience. You can do things such as pick clothing for Mulan, click about the various villages of the kingdom to find items, and the similar, as you go through the storyline in the movie while directly influencing things to move the story forward properly. It's borderline in how close it really matches or flows, but it truly isn't a movie-based game in the true sense. Sadly, there is only the Game Boy version of the movie-based game that was made to relate to this movie, and that is the one that will be reviewed here when the time comes to do this film. Not this interesting spin-off type of game. Judge Dredd. The first-person perspective shooter game is not based off of the film of the same name that stars Sylvester Stallone. This is directly based off the comic book that the film was based off of in the first place. Even though it uses FMVs and vocals in between stages and has a full storyline that isn't laid out like a comic book, it's still not movie-based. There are various games based off of the film that came prior to this game's release, and those will be what's reviewed here when the time comes to tackle this movie. This is one of those games that seems movie-based when you play it, but it truly isn't. The Land Before Time, Great Valley Racing Adventure. This game is original content, and it's also trying to get in on all the racing-themed games that were popular around the time of this game's release. Even though the second movie is called The Great Valley Adventure, this is more of a spin-off using the area familiar from the films and not based on the movie or any of the movies. This is a racing game that has you using one of the characters from the Land Before Time series of movies as you race through familiar and expected type of landscapes, trying to get to the goal faster than the other dinosaur racer. Besides that, it uses characters and worlds from the films. It is a generic and basic racing game geared to the younger audience and doesn't really relate to any of the films. The Land Before Time, Return to the Great Valley. A game that bases itself on the universe of the Land Before Time films, but has an original story and is not based off of any particular film. It is the typical no-frills type of game that will have you in the role of one of the dinosaurs as you explore about in a game geared towards the younger audiences. You get to choose one of the main characters and explore through the area in platforming-like fashion in this basic type of game. But it won't have anything to do with the films and is basically a spin-off milking off of the franchise, and this is far from the only game made based off of this series. Another not related game. Monsters, Inc. Scream Team. This game is a prequel to the events as seen in the Pixar movie Monsters, Inc. that has Mike and Sully trying to get a job with Monsters, Inc. in a totally original and new story that tries to tie into the original film. While this does tie into the events of the film and uses the characters, it is actually not based on the movie as it's just a continuation made up just for this game, so it's not applicable as being something that can be reviewed here. Shrek Treasure Hunt. In a very weird offshoot, this time we have a game that takes place after the events of the original Shrek movie, with you using said character to hunt down missing items that are scattered all along his swamp and the other locations as seen in the movie. It's actually a pretty bad game and not a very good use of the license. Donkey doesn't even make an appearance and the game leaves a lot to be desired. Definitely not based off of the films, and it's an original and new adventure using the characters from said universe. Star Wars Episode 1, Jedi Power Battles. As mentioned on my review for the original movie-based game on the PlayStation 1, this is a spin-off of the movie Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and not actually the original movie-based game that was already reviewed here. There were a few games that expanded on the Star Wars Episode 1 universe, and this is another one of them. This game will have you using the various Jedi Masters as seen in that film, and put you in various battle-type moments where you have to fight your way through stages based off of the film's location. This game does take place during the events of the film, but it's not an official movie-based game, and is more of an expansion or spin-off of said film. Top Gun, Fire at Will. As is the case with the other spin-offs based around this franchise, this is the same situation, taking the well-known movie franchise and basing a whole new adventure around it. In what basically comes off as a typical plane shooter, where you are using the iconic jet from the movie and blasting all other objects out of the sky in the process. It does reference the film and even uses live-action video of one of the actors, and it is indeed Maverick again who is flying the jet plane you control. But again, it's unrelated to anything from the first movie, and it's fully original and new in content made just for this video game. Just another game using the franchise to make another jet plane shooting game. Toy Story Racer. Another in the racing genre that was so popular around this time of the game's release, this time it takes the familiar Toy Story characters that were in the first film and puts them into a kart racing situation. Not really basing itself on the movie, but using all the familiar locations and settings from the movie to base the various racetracks off of it. It's a true Mario Kart clone that is fun for what it is, but definitely not movie-based. The Jungle Book, Rhythm and Groove. An interesting take on the story of the Disney animated feature, The Jungle Book. This version has you retelling the story of the film through music, with you having to use either a dance pad or controller to time the entries just right as they show up on screen in tune to the music, full of various songs from the film and some original songs to help tell the full story of The Jungle Book. This game is a spin-off and not a true rendition of the story of the movie as so many other games prior to this one have done. So while it's fun, unique, and an interesting take on the story, it's not something that truly fits with the theme of the show in reviewing movie-based games. Warpath, Jurassic Park. A true spin-off of the various movies and books in the Jurassic Park series. This time it has the player using the dinosaurs themselves to fight other dinosaurs in a weird one-on-one fighting game. It does use the famous and familiar backgrounds and locations from the series though to base off of things, and of course the iconic dinosaurs highlighted in said movies are here. But besides that, it's just a dinosaur fighting game using the license to base the dinosaurs off of in it. There are many games that are spun off of the movies and have nothing to do with said movies, but are original content all to their own. This is another example of that, but it's unique and different. I'll give them that. To Be Determined. These are the hard to determine if they qualify movie-based games. The following games are to be determined if they will be reviewed here or not. Reasons for their being hard to determine are listed with each game. Alien Trilogy. This game is actually based off the first three movies of the Alien series, and it doesn't just do it in parts, but it has you venturing through first-person style while you deal with elements as found in the trilogy of movies. It's a basic shooter that has you in the role of Ripley from said movies, and does indeed have the aliens from the films as well. But it's really a multi-movie game, not basing it off on the particular films, but the whole series at once. It's still to be determined though, as I may do multi-movie based reviews as special editions to highlight games that were dedicated to more than one movie at a time, as there are quite a few of them. For now though, it just doesn't fit into the theme of the show to do this game. Die Hard Trilogy. This game is based off of the first three movies in the Die Hard series, with each part of the game focusing on one of the movies that make up the trilogy, as you of course take control of the Bruce Willis character, John McClane, from start to finish. It's another to be determined as it's a multi-movie game. Those will be done not as regular reviews, but as special editions highlighting the series itself over just a particular movie that it's relating to. It definitely is based off of the three films and does them in an interesting way, but for now it doesn't fit into the theme of the show with games being based off of one film at a time to compare it to. So we'll see how or if we can work this one in the future. The Lion King, Simba's Mighty Adventure. While at first this game seemed to be just another retelling of The Lion King done in video game format, this is actually a multi-movie based game, with it dealing with story and elements from both The Lion King and Lion King 2, Simba's Pride, in one nice package. So since it does deal with both movies, it is a game that may have to be done as a special edition multi-movie episode, rather than just focusing on one or the other film to base it off of. I'll have to play it more and see how it goes with this one, as far as determining where this updated Lion King game fits into things, if at all. War Games, DEFCON 1. I already did the official movie-based game that related to the movie War Games, but here we have a more updated game that really tries to delve back into the whole Cold War experience with you using the main computers of NORAD and Whopper as you go against the other country as per the movie. It's more of a game with you doing real-time war strategies as you take control of droves of units at a time to take down the enemy. But it does have a lot of references, nods, and inclusions from the film this is all based off of, so it's a weird game that is sorta kinda based on it, but very loosely if at all. We will see if this one fits in as another game based off of the film. As a reminder, games based on the following do not fit into the theme of the show. Games based on comic books and not movies. Games based on TV shows and not movies. Sequels to games based on movies but do not relate to the movie itself. Games that use characters from the movie in an unrelated spin-off type of game. Also note that this show focuses on games related to the North American market, so also excluded are PlayStation exclusive games in the Asian-only market, games that were never released in the North American market. Various games not in the North American market may still make appearances as special edition episodes. Games that have to be translated to English. In conclusion, of course, this list may be incomplete, contain errors, or change at any time. This is a reference to what won't appear and why something may not. Keep in mind what was shown here as you make a game request. Game requests are always appreciated and encouraged. Thanks again to all who take the time to suggest a movie-based game they want to see reviewed. Let me know if you think a PlayStation game should or shouldn't be on this list and why. And that's all for now, from movies to video games reviews. Thanks again for all suggestions, and hopefully this helped to understand what PlayStation 1 games didn't make the cut and why.